everybody, it's Suffolk Blue, all the way from merry old England. How the devil are you? I hope you are well. Welcome back to Minecraft, welcome back to Direwolf 20, welcome back to the View Variety server. It's a sort of midweek episode today. I decided we were going to do a bit more Minecraft this week because I need to make a bit more progress on some things. So I'm going to put some of the other episodes to one side just to focus a little bit on the Minecraft. I hope you don't mind. If you do, tough. So what we're going to do, we're going to need to focus on making a tree farm. Let me go and show you what happened. Now, I did do a collaboration with the Digimaster, but unfortunately my version of that collab became corrupted. So I'm not able to show you the video, but let me go and show you anyway what we did and what he helped me with. Now, if you remember a little while ago, I said that Digi was going to give us a hand in doing getting hold of a hungry node, which we're going to turn into a giant node to be able to help power things. Oh, and I put in the chandeliers, look, and they go all the way up and they're held in place firmly at the top. This is just fantasy block all the way down, and I think they look pretty good. What I had to do also in here is I've used some of that gaseous illuminatus, or whatever it's called, the gas, a light in a bottle, basically, just to lighten everything up so we get away, we don't get any mobs forming. But there we go, I think they look pretty cool. So those are our chandeliers. But let me go and show you what I was actually going to show you. Down, this is obviously our boiler room. Empty space, going to turn this into a spawning area. Down again, there, pure evil, look at it. That is our hungry node, and as you can see, we did a bit of decoration down here, just to sort of put it all in. If I get in the corner here, I'm not going to get sucked in, but you can see that we have got a hungry node in its shell. We're not doing anything with the hungry node at the moment. It's been captured and pulled across, and as I say, sadly, we did do that in a collaboration with Digi. Digi hopefully is going to be able to show from his point of view, but sadly, I will not be able to show from mine, because mine didn't come out. But we have built, as you can see, this sort of dark and ominous... I don't know what you'd call it, really, like a chamber to hold the Eye of Terror there that's sucking us in. I have also used watered glass around the edge. We've also watered these pillars because I have been busy with the foci. I am going to be honest. I've made some additional foci off camera just so I could start using some of these. The one that we've used here is the warding one, and as you can see, if I put the warding on, you can see that all of the blocks in there have been warded. That just means that the hungry block can't destroy them. We haven't been able to ward the carpenter's blocks. Not sure how it's going to react. That is open at the top, though, so if it was going to destroy any of those top obelisks or anything, I feel it would have done it by now already. But it hasn't done it, so these are all warded, it's all protected. This is just black carpet, and it's just going to be a sort of dark and devious place at the bottom of the world where our Eye of Terror is going to be held. This aura in there is going to get huge. It's going to be massive as it sort of is fed, and we need to start the construction to feed it. Okay. Another foci I used and found really useful is this one, which is the what's it called? It's the uprising. And essentially, what the uprising one for us does is it allows us to fly, which is great. We can obviously already fly, but it does mean that I can get away from the suction of a hungry node, because if you notice, the closer you get to this, the harder it is to really pull away, and really close to it, you really can't get away from it at all. So we're going to be growing that node. Let's go up, whoops, and up, and you can see we're at bedrock level. So there we go, we can come out now. We can, look at us flying, I'm not pressing any buttons, the wand's doing all the magic. It's quite quick. I mean, it's using air is the essence it's using to achieve this. Bump, and there we go. Lovely. So we're going to be feeding that hungry node. Now, what are we going to feed it? That's a good question. What we're going to feed it is essentially crafting tables, because that's got all the primal essences in. But I'm also going to throw in some other stuff, because I got a feeling that we can feed it lots more than just crafting tables. I'd quite like to feed it some gold blocks and stuff as well to get some Luxor in there, because when we energize it, it's going to take all of that goodness and turn it into primal essence to fuel and power our magic over there. What we need then is a farming station, and we're going to use Ender.io. Now, I've never really used Ender.io for anything, so this is going to be amazingly bad, because I don't really know what I'm doing. But who needs to know what they're doing? Let's just have some fun and find out. Now, so far, We need to make some electrical steel, which I've already made. I've already got some of that, which is simply iron, coal powder, and silicon in an alloy smelter, which we've already done. I've already got my diamond hoe. Pulsating crystal is just this pulsating iron nugget, which is ender, what's it called, an ender pearl and iron in a smelter, and with a diamond in the middle. So we've already done that, but we are missing a machine. We need a machine. What we need is a slice and splice. And in order to make that, we need a machine chassis. Well, I've already got a machine chassis. Already got one of those. But what we do need is solarium. So in order to make solarium, what we're going to need is a load of this stuff, soul sand, and some gold. Now, I already made a couple of ingots over here. And then I thought, no, let's video this. Let's show the viewers us making stuff. So here we go. We've got two pieces of solarium in there already. We need how many? How many did I say? Where's my slice and splice? I've lost it. Can't see it. I think it's two, slice and splice. Oh, wow, one, two, three, four, five. So we've got two, we need three more. So all we do is you go one, two, three, and one, two, three. Now, we've also got to move, if you can see, we've got no lava coming through. So I'm assuming that this is starting to run down a little bit. Yeah, a little bit. But we do have our old Stirling generator here doing a fantastic job and keeping us going. So these are now in here doing that. Shall I go and move that while I'm waiting? Let me go and do that. I'll make a cut and just quickly go and move the generator around in the nether. And when I come back, that soul sand will be ready. And you won't have missed anything. So I shall be right back. And welcome back. So there we go. Just a quick journey over. And now we've got lava pouring into the system and everything seems to be fine. Let's come back over here, grab this solarium sand stuff. Okay, and what else do we need to make this? Well, we need the chassis frame, which we've already made. So we've got a chassis frame. One, two, three. One, two. I think we needed a head. I know we need a head. Let's use that creep head up because it's in the way. We need a head. And then I think we need shears and an axe, but now I can't find that again. I don't know why I find it so difficult to see this license, but there she is. So I need shears and an iron axe. So have we got iron on us? Got electrical steel, we have iron on us. Okay, so I need an iron axe, which I don't have. Let's go and make that over here since I've started using that bench. Bump bump and bump bump bump. Oh, I'm using the electrical steel. That doesn't work. You. Bum, bum, bum. Thought I was going mad for a second. And shears. What are you again? There we go. Lovely. Let's not hit anything with that. Let's go and put it in the system. I think a creeper head will work. We'll find out in a second. Shears and a slice and splice. Here we go. So we need to plug this in. We need to get some power to it. Well, luckily, we've just got a load of power, haven't we? Where could it go? Where could it go? It could probably go just over top here, really, I suppose. I'm not going to use it very often. On the back of this one, maybe? Something like that. There's the power going in. Excellent! We now have a slice and splice. A slice and splice. Now, what do we need for... What did I say we needed? For this ender farming station. We're going to need... Yes, now a Z-Logic controller. So we need a zombie head, two solarium, two silicon and some redstone. So we need some more solarium. Just a couple of pieces more. Which is just some more gold and some more soul sand. Which we can do. I've got gold on me. I have. One, two. One, two. Let's go and throw that in the system. Is it raining? Yeah, raining again. I don't know why this island, I think, is the wettest island I've ever been on. Sort of... Oh, wrong place. Sort of... just continually wet. Okay, two of those. Two of those. Off you go. Make those, please. And we're going to need to make another machine frame after this. So let's go and make one of those really quickly because they're actually pretty quick and easy to make. We are going to need two of those, I think. Take a stack, why not? So I'm going to need some of these. Because we're going to need to make a capacitor thingy, aren't we, for this? Basic capacitor, there we go. So we need copper. Have I got any copper on me? Nope. Luckily, we have some over here. Copper. So one copper. Redstone, redstone. 1, 2, 3, 4. There it is. We then have 1, 2, 3, 4. And if memory serves, 1, 2, 3, 4. Yes! Excellent. So that replaces the machine frame we just used to make the slicing splice. Hopefully we've got the soul sand. Let's go and make a Z-Logic controller. There's the soul sand. One. Oh, whoops. Bump. Solarium. Okay, slice and splice. Are you ready? You are. We need to put in, though, don't we? Again, I need to put in another couple of those, don't I? Because I'm sure you have to have things in there, otherwise they didn't work. So we need to make... luckily, we still have this on us. One of those. Iron. Lovely. And... Lovely. Right. Let's go and make that. Can't wait to get in a better crafting area. This is so spread out all over the shop. When we get in the new base and we have one of our downstairs areas, it's going to be amazing. So the axe can go in there. You can go in there. Excellent. So, how do we make that head again? We need to put solarium, silicon. So we need another head. Solarium, dom. Let's get a zombie head, because we need a zombie head. And luckily, we have lots of zombie heads, because we had a zombie in our spawner for ages, and we do have one or two zombie heads. Some of which are underneath our infusion altar, which keeps everything a little bit more stable. So I was quite pleased with that. So if we put these in here, does it just go? Yeah, oof! Off it goes, it's slicing and splicing. Come on. I'm assuming that the zombie head is the controlling unit, like the CPU, using zombies to control things. There it is, Z-Logic controller. Excellent. So, slice and splice worked. We have a control unit. So the next thing is to put all this together and make that ender farm. And then I suppose we're going to have to get some power to it as well. What am I doing? I don't know what I'm doing, really. Hold on. Where's the farm? It's that funny little shape. Diamond hoe, electrical steel. Okay, so donk, donk. Donk, dump, and then bump, 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 bump. Yes! Hold shift. Plants are harvested. Crops requires power and appropriate tools, a hoe or an axe. Looting fortune and tools applied when harvesting. Upgrade with capacitors to increase range. Upgrade also increases power use. So the same as every other one. So we need to have a little area for this and pop it down, and then we've got to get some power to it. Now, what I'm thinking really is, can I go straight up from here? Now, I don't know what straight up from here. Obviously we'll go outside, but I don't know whether I can... It would be great if I could just go straight up, yeah? So that we can just take the power cables up. So let's get our wand, and... We're not going to be underwater, I know that much. Because... Over there, see? It's trees! But we are directly over rock, which is unfortunate. And we're on this mountainside again, which is a little bit unfortunate, but I suppose we could make a bit of space just by using the old wand. We've got a lot of these creeper plants about, which are annoying. Let's take some of this dirt, make a bit of space, take out these creepers. I don't know how much space we need for this. One assumes it's not going to be a particularly... Oh my goodness, how many creeper plants did we grow up here? It's crazy talk. Loads of them. Okay. This tree could be done with getting rid of, so let's go back down the hole and get... Ooh, it's not the easiest route up, is it? Tree. You'll do. Come here. This is our big axe that we use normally when we're doing silverwoods. Now, I'm not going to grow silverwoods in here because you're not going to get enough saplings to keep it all alive. Lump, there we go. Take all of that out, and that will now take itself away, all in one go. Lovely. Let's take out these because we don't want rock here, we want dirt. You can see our pipes underneath. Whoops. Let's take that out. Okay, so with this extra dirt that we've now got, let's just dirt this all the way across. Hold on, not obviously putting it here because this is where our unit's going to go. I'm assuming I can put power to it underneath. We'll find out in a sec. Whoops. Tree's nearly gone. So we'll have to use ordinary oak trees or silver bells. Silver bells would probably be okay, but we just need to make a lot of wood that we can feed into an automatic crafting unit so that we can make... I didn't know that was up there. Wintry hive. So that we can make crafting tables and then automatically drop them, just like Digi did. In fact, we're going to be copying Digi pretty close to that. Go away. Oh, bees. Got the bees come out of it. How cool. We haven't got any bees before. Bees, another thing I want to do as well, so there's lots to do on this server still. What's changed since I've seen you last? Oh, well, Ector's gone, and we wish Ector all the very best. He's gone over to Hypermine, so we really do wish him the very best, and do keep checking out his videos, because he's a great YouTuber. I love watching him. So he'll be missed on this server. Sad I never got to do a collab with him. If he's around at any point and I can grab him, I might see if we can do something together, because it would be awesome. But, you know, Ector's out and about there, so go and check that out. I suppose I could have gone to Ector's place and stolen everything rather than making it myself, because I'm pretty sure Ector made one of these. But it's nice to make it yourself, because then you know what you're doing with it. Okay, so that's sort of a bit of an area. It's not brilliant, but this is just our tree farm up here, out of the way. Let's just roll this back in another level. I love the wands. I love when wands do this. It's just so good. There we go. Pick it all up. Oops, they just spawned right where I didn't want them to be. Again, I'm not 100% sure at how wide this has to be. One assumes it's not particularly wide to start off with, because like most Ender IO stuff, you have to put like capacitors and stuff in it to make it bigger and do stuff. So I think that should be okay. Now you can't, I'm assuming, if I put it in the middle, we could probably power it from the back. And, oh, so southwest, oh, here we go, yeah. So this would be like, we need an axe to put in here. I don't know whether I need to put two in, or whether I just have to put one in. No matter, we'll find out soon enough. Oh, there's a tree. Now, have I got any saplings that I can use, and I need to make an axe. Now, I could make a diamond axe, which I'm assuming would last longer. It doesn't, we've got loads of diamonds anyway. 1, 2, 3. I don't know if a double axe works as any better, but we'll see. 1, 2, 3. Diamond axe. Do you have any saplings? Yes, I do. Yes, I do. Oak saplings, 32. That should be enough, I'd have thought. Oh, and I need some power. Gotta run power to it. Power. 7, that might be enough. We've got a lot of creeper seeds, which is annoying. Let's put these in our seed thing out of the way. Okay, so we've got an axe. Right, if I'm going to run power up here... So, where's my power? Will this be the right power, even? Who knows? Well, it runs the slice and splice, which is Ender IO, so there shouldn't be a problem. Do you reckon I can still put that on top of there? I'd love to be able to put that on top of there. That would save so much hassle. Shall we see? Okay. You go there. Boom. Oh, yeah. Look. Glowy. So that's glowing. So if I put an axe in... it's got no seeds, it says, which is a fair point. It doesn't have any seeds. But if I put in saplings, does it do anything? Oh, it spits them out. Oh, no. Where did that come from? That's the wrong type of sapling. So, oh, we've got to put things in. 1, 2, 3, 4. But it's planted them. How do you keep it being planted? Oh, crumbs. So that's now planted everything. And one assumes where does it throw the stuff out to? Am I going to need to put a chest on it? I must do, because I can't. It's got nowhere else to go if not. That must be its internal storage, one assumes. And we need to pump that out. Can I pump it out behind? If I come down here. Because I can go into a better barrel or something, couldn't I? And then across, maybe? I could go into a better barrel, which could be here? With an item thingy, what's it? Let's go right up, actually. Oh, don't go too far up. We can take that out and that out. Yeah. So, we need to make a better barrel. Oh, as I walk into a wall. I've got a better barrel, actually. I probably just use one of those. Must have an empty barrel around here somewhere I don't use. I'll need to upgrade it, though, and I can show you how to do that, too, with the Jabba Batter barrels, upgrade things. What have you got in there? Quicksand. You can come out. Nobody uses that. Old nonsense. You can go in there for now. Let's get the dolly. Dolly. I like the dolly. Have you ever used these? I mean, you don't have to use a dolly to move these, otherwise I could just take it off. I want to show you. Here we go. You move a little bit slower, but you do get to move it around whilst it's still full with stuff, which I think is pretty cool. It's a great way of moving things around. We are going to need to upgrade. Upgrade? Now, what about the apples and stuff? I hadn't thought about apples, because we're going to get other things from those trees, aren't we? I wonder, does it shave them, or does it just chop them? I'm assuming because I've only put an axe in there, it's going to just chop. So we could still get apples. So we probably might want to make another barrel specifically for apples. So let's go and get a better barrel. A better barrel. Better barrel? Better barrel. A chest with some wood and a top. So we want a chest with some wood and a top. Will you work? You will. There we go. And then we're going to have to... I wonder the item connections between these. I don't know what pipes you use. I could use what I've used elsewhere, but I'm not 100% convinced it's going to do an awful lot. Now, you can go, because it's light enough in here anyway. Let's take you out. Oh, that doesn't need to go, but you do. Okay. Second better barrel can go there. And we need some pipe work. Basically, just one pipe. I'm assuming you can do both. I assume these things. Let's go and have a look. Whoops, fall down. Oh, bit of lag. Because over here, when we do the... Now, again, see, but this isn't Ender IO. We've been using these ones, which is the thermodynamic stuff. Now, I don't know whether that talks to Ender IO. I haven't used any Ender IO here, I don't think. It's all thermal. So, in terms of Ender IO, what are the pipes? Do they have pipes? One assumes they must. Can't see any pipes. Or anything that looks like a pipe. What's that? So, tank valve, energy input, Ender tank. Ooh, that's an idea. I could put it straight into an Ender chest. Could do something like that. Can't see any pipes. Some wireless powered light. What are you? Your reservoir. The vat. Yeah, I can't see any pipes. So I have to wonder whether or not it's going to work. If not, we'll just have to find... We'll go and check out what others have done and see, but I think let's give it a whirl and see what happens. So we already have, where am I? I forgot which room I'm in. We already have some of these, but I don't know how many I've got. Item duct. Not many, 9. I don't think that's gonna be enough. And I'm even assuming we're gonna get any apples, we may not. I don't quite know how this all works, so we shall soon find out. Now, do you take that will you connect? So you're sort of suggesting to me that you might, because you do connect. One has come down. 1, 2. Backwards. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Ooh, so close. Okay. So let's go and quickly make some of these. That's a pain. I do have a reinforced retriever up there, though. I suppose, actually, I could steal some of the stuff from the machines over here, because we're not really using them anymore. Although, it would be nice to keep them. They can't be too difficult to build. Although, I could steal all of this, you see. Yeah, we're not using them anymore. Might as well take this up and then put it back. Bom, 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 bom. Bom, 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 bom. Because everything else, you see, goes straight into the bin, and then we don't have to worry about it. Let's put dirt there for now, it doesn't matter. Bom, 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 bom. Good. So we've got 9 more item ducks and a couple of those retrievers. Which I think is going to be for apples. I don't think we get mushrooms off these. It's difficult to tell. Bomp and bomp. We're not going to really know whether it does anything until any one of these have grown. Let's move this out of the way. Where's my wand? Thank you. Boom. Right. Oh, now why have you grown spruce? Because that's not what I want at all. Bomp, bomp, bomp. Whoa! Cut it down. Yeah, well, yes. Now, is it going to do anything with them? Probably not, because there's nothing in the machine, but it's going to be stored. Yes, and we do get apples. Oh, that's so useful. So we know we get apples. Can't put apples back. So you can't put anything back once it's in there. Okay. Oh, goodness gracious, it goes at a rate. Right, let's get down here then. So we know we're going to have apples, and we know we're going to have... So I'm going to put retriever on here and here. And come to here, and we're going to say whitelist apples. Don't know whether it's going to spit anything out, because it may not have just taken any apples. Alright, so that's apples. And then this one, let's say whitelist. Don't think I have to turn them on, but I might have to. Oak wood. Let's have a look. Do I have to turn you on? Ignored. Oh, it's on. Ignored. Yes! Look! Ooh! Things are working. Now, have you got anything else in here which is going to cause me issues or pain? No. So you haven't made anything new, and we have got a little bit of that going on, but that's fine. Your saplings you've decided to put back. Yeah, so it's kept the saplings. Let's lock that in. So now I think it's just going to build all around it. But there we go. We now will be able to have... Now, what we are going to need to put on here, though, absolutely going to need to put on here, is some upgrades. Upgrade! Can I get an upgrade? Let's go and do that. Over here, get rid of that. Now, for the upgrades, I can't remember what we need. I think the first one's wood, and then we go to iron, and then we can go to gold, and then we go to diamond and emerald. So, jab up. Upgrade. Can I get an upgrade? Oh, yes, that's right. Fences. Fences and wood. So, the fences, we haven't got many of those, but we can make some by going whoomp. Great job. And now, how do they go? Was it that one, that one, that one, and that one? Whoops. And then... Is there any wood in there? Where's my wood? Mm-mm-mm. Does it matter what wood? I'm not sure whether it matters what wood. Let's take some wood from here. Let's have a look. Boom, 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 boom. Yes! Okay, so that worked. We want 2 of those. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. So this is just going to give us the upgrades on these barrels to start with. We're then going to need to go up to iron, and then up to the next lot, because we're probably going to need to max these out. What have I done wrong? I've got to put the two together, haven't I? Do I not? Oh, there we go. Right click. Shift and right click. Boom. So, we've upgraded those to start with. That takes us to 48 of 4,000 items. Next ones up from there will be the iron ones. So, we can go and quickly have a look at doing some of those. And then, what I'll do off camera is I will begin... What's the upgrade for number 2? Same again. So, do I have any more sticks? How many more sticks? So we can take these and make some sticks. Then we take these and make some fences. And we can go 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2. And then 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2. Okay. And this will just mean that we can store all our wood and our apples and such like, which will be good. I am going to need to get more power supply probably for these. Oh, what am I doing? That one. Bump. And bump. So now that's up to... We've got upgrade to 3 slots. We are going to need to upgrade now item levels more. And you can see this is the item level, so storage upgrades. You need 3 slots for this, and you make that just by putting 3 storage upgrades together. And our storage upgrade is a better barrel and 2 pistons. So, did I make any pistons? I'm sure I had loads of pistons made for these sorts of things, but you go through them quite quickly when you're using barrels. Can't see any pistons going on. I need 4 pistons at least. I think 2, 4. So actually, I'm going to need a lot more than that. Probably a lot more. Did I make any wood? I did not. Got wood in here. You do. Thanks very much. I think that one goes there. I think there goes something like this. Remember how to make these things now. Oh no, it's across the top. That's right. So you don't make pistons very often. 2. And then when you forget, you forget. Like so. We want more. Actually, can I just do a lot of run of those? One of those. Halve them up. Bonk. I've got 9. Any more cobble anywhere? Thank you. Tap. We want 12. Really, get another 12 out of these. Let's do it this way. Bump, 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 bump. And a wallop. 21. So that should give us plenty of these. Do I need to make barrels for those upgrades? I do. It's all about the barrels. How many empty chests? We've got 6. Do I have any more? I've got 3, 4, 5. Okay. We'll do it this way to start with. You. Like so. Make some better barrels there. Some better barrels there. That gives us 5. Bump and a bump. Gives us a bump. Oh, I want one more, really. Because then I can go like that. That gives us the 3. Oh, where's me pistons? Have I got me... Where's me box? 1. Let's say there was one in here. Just looking for a slab without having to... Yes, greatwood slabs. They'll do. Come with me. Come with me, greatwood slabs. Missed ya. And 1 there. So that gives us... what does it give us? 1 better barrel. And then we can do another 2 pistons. Another one of those. 3... and a 3. And then what we can do is we can go over to our barrels. Let's see whether anything else has been made in these barrels. Yes. We can go on. So 16,000 items now. We'll do the same with the apples. And we'll just keep doing that, I think. We'll keep plugging them up and getting them working. He says no seeds. No seeds. I have no seeds. But one assumes... Can I... How do you... Share out the seeds, man. Share out the seeds. So as we get more oak sapling... Well, that doesn't need to be any bigger than that. That can pretty much run and do as it does. So the last thing I'm going to do at the top here is just do that. Ah, not that, because that's really ugly. It wasn't what I wanted to do at all. Go away. Bump. Is dirt is what I want to put there. There we go. We'll leave that open for now, although normally I would make that pretty, but we're not going to, because this is a working farm. It's not the end result. We won't ever have a farm that looks quite that ugly normally. But there we go. So today we've managed to get our farm on the go to get the wood. The next thing we have to do is looking at using Steve's factory in order to start looking at self-creating the crafting benches. I'm going to need to finish off these two. Hopefully these are just going to keep going and doing stuff. You got power and everything. You have... Yeah. Okay, well there we go. So thanks very much for watching. I hope you've enjoyed the episode. If you did, please hit that like button. It does help the channel out. It helps getting these videos seen by people. If you're not a subscriber yet and you've happened upon this channel and had a look, please consider also hitting the subscribe button. It'd be great to have you along for the journey. I've got some gold in there still, haven't I? Or aluminium, brass and aluminium in there. Goodness gracious. But remember, this is the Beaver Variety server. So please also check out all the description, in my description, all the links to all the other players there who have been on this server. So please consider having a look at those and subscribing to their channels too. But until next time, when we come back and work a little bit more on feeding our Eye of Terror node, you take care yourselves, and I'll see you soon.